come on and fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near, you may hear all the angels cheer, because we're together weather-wise. It's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon. They say, come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so very near, you might even hear a whole gang of cheers, just because we're together weather-wise. It's such a cuckoo day. You just say those words and we'll take our birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's so perfect for a flying honeymoon. Oh, babe, come fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly.
Pack up, let's fly away. Pack a small bag. Good evening. Good evening. Happy Friday to you all. Just hanging out. Thought I'd do a flight on this wonderful Friday evening. Question for you both, for you all. I wanted to know if you wanted to fly somewhere dangerous this evening. There's a snowstorm in Buffalo, New York right now. And I was thinking it'd be fun to fly into Buffalo right now. It's like thunder snow. Right now, we're also in a very dangerous place. We're in Cleveland, Ohio. Which, being as gay as we all are, it's a very dangerous place. We're in Ohio. So, let me redo my flight plan, and let's go to Buffalo, New York. So we're flying Delta Airlines on a very unrealistic flight, going from Cleveland to Buffalo. I feel like Buffalo is really close to Cleveland, isn't it? It's really close, isn't it? No? I mean, let's see. I'm looking at the route here. Buffalo, Cleveland. It's only 192 nautical miles. You know what? I hear you, man. Let's get the fuck out of Ohio. It's a really short flight. But that means we don't have to wait very long to get to where we need to be. So let's see. All right. I'm filing my flight plan right now. You guys ready for thunder snow? Louis Vuitton. I'm pretty sure the Buffalo airport is like closed right now. I don't know. How are you guys doing this evening? Made you look. Yeah, 8-1, baby. Those Minnesota Vikings. How about that? Full of Indian food. That's nice. Okay, we are going to Buffalo, New York. Because it is fucking incredibly dangerous right now. I checked the ATIS, which, if you're wondering what an ATIS is, it's like the weather information for the airport. And it actually didn't look too bad. Winds are 220 to 11 knots with 10 miles visibility. Few clouds at 2,200 feet. Or no, 22,000 feet. Overcast at 6,000 feet. ILS runway 23 approach in use. Noticed all air mission. All ramps path patchy ice and compacted snow. And sanded. West remain overnight ramp work. Snow 15 feet snow piling and holy shit. There's a lot of fucking snow on the ground in Buffalo, New York right now. 15 feet of, like, piled up snow. Not on the ground, but, like, you know, like, when they pile it up. All right, we got to load the plane up. Load aircraft. All right. So let's go to our config here. Yeah, so we're going to fly into a snowstorm. I'm really excited if you're just joining us here. So, by the way, if you're wondering why I'm streaming on Hoscord Streams, it's because I am preparing for my new show, Flight, which is going to be in all of December. Where it's going to be me and a featured guest flying a real commercial jet, having to overcome obstacles that are thrown at us throughout flight with minimal flight experience. I've rented out all the simulators, so that's exciting. And I'm trying to learn how to fly the A320 because a couple of the flights that I'm going to be doing are going to be with it. So, yeah. Shout out to who? Shout out to who, Ryan? All right, let's insert that. Shout out to your mom. She was great last night. That's fucking sick of you. All right, cost index of 25. What's our flight level? Shit. What flight level did I put on this flight plan? 27,000 feet. Negative 50 degrees up there. Holy shit. All right, let's go to our flight plan. We're going out of Cleveland. And our departure is... whatever this is. We're going 2-4 left. PLFD1. And then we're going on the... where the hell that is. Transition, insert into the route. That's pretty much our route right there, ladies and gentlemen. You guys want me to call ATC? We got ATC on this flight. So we gotta call him right now. Let's see, we got a Cleveland. Cleveland Center's 119.875. Radio check.
1039 is 14 miles from the airport. Turn left, heading 240. Maintain 3,000 till establishment localized are cleared. ILS runway 21 left approaching.
Left 240. Maintain 3,000 till established. Clear for the ILS 21 left approach. 1039.
1039. Check your airspeed. Show 120 and reducing rapidly.
I got about a 40-knot headwind here.
Holy shit. Cleveland Center, Delta 2385, IFR clearance to Buffalo.
Delta 2385, Cleveland Center, clear to the Buffalo Airport via the Pink Floyd 1 departure, Duker transition, direct Buffalo Airport. Main correction, climb via SID, squawk 5733.
Cleared to the Buffalo International Airport, squawk 5733, Delta 2385.
Runway 24 left for departure, call for taxi.
24 left for departure, we'll give you a call for taxi. Thanks, Delta 2385.
Giant 8835, you send up pilot's discretion.
All right.
12,000. The Grand Rapids altimeter,
so,
3005.
PD to 12,000.
I just got my IFR clearance. So basically, before you take off on a flight, you've got to call for what they call IFR clearance. It's called IFR, stands for instrument flight rules. So for planes like commercial jets and planes that are equipped to fly IFR, when you go to an airport, you get IFR clearance, I should say. And basically it gives you... clears you on the route that you filed with them to your the airport that you're going to. So we've just done that. Typically at an airport, you have clearance delivery. The air traffic controllers at an airport, you have clearance delivery. You have a ground controller. So clearance delivery, they'll handle like the IFR clearances. Then you have a ground controller who handles the taxiways on the ground at the airport. The tower controller who clears everybody for departure and takeoff. The departure controller who will control the airspace of departing aircraft. The center controller who controls like airplanes, like pretty much at cruise altitude and right before they would contact the approach controller. And the approach controller has the airspace that guides them into the airport. But I'm on a professional server and... you essentially, they're not staffed with all those controllers. So you contact the controller that is like if you're a center controller on this server, you'll control everything below you if it's not staffed. So I contacted the center controller. Does that make any sense? It's probably a bad way to explain it. Whatever. You guys don't give a fuck. It's like, shut up and fly that plane. Get us out of Ohio. Get us out of fucking Ohio. Where's the gate? Where the fuck is the gate? Oh my god! I've been pushing back for like the last 15 minutes. I'm just in the middle of the taxiway. Look, I'm look at this. I'm like, what the fuck? I've been backing up for like ever. With the parking brake on. Shit. What the I didn't even know we were moving. Oh well. So stupid. Oh well, let's get the fuck out of here, huh? What do you guys think? We got to take care of a couple things here, do some calculations. Then we can get the fuck out of here. Let's get the fuck out of here and go to very dangerous, allegedly, Buffalo, New York. We got to fill out a couple things, though, here in the this page. Zero fuel weight is 131.0. / 29.5. You guys got anything planned for Thanksgiving? Block fuel, 13.0. Nope. Being alive, hopefully. Well, yeah. It's a good idea. I like that plan. Hello, fangirl. How are you? You're not going to die on this flight. We will get there safely. Trust me. I'm a professional. You guys want to listen to some Christmas music? I feel like it's that type of night.
Runway 24 right.
Okay, we'll descend via the rolling 2, and we're expecting 24 right for Hopkins Delta 22.
Is the ATC too loud or is it good?
Southwest 3251, 10 miles from Clump, turn left, heading 260, maintain 3,000 till established smoke clouds are cleared, ILS runway 23, Buffalo.
Can we get that hang one more time for Southwest 3251?
260.
I love the ATC chatter, it makes it feel like more realistic and stuff. 3,000
till established, Southwest 3251.
Start the turn. There you go. The 4116, I have a short-term memory. Runway 2 on left, you are cleared to 2 lane.
All right, let's get our flaps to 1.
2 lane, South 4116.
Southwest 542, Lee Myers Space, Chicago is offline. ATC services are terminated and your frequency change approved.
Good night, Southwest 542.
You guys remember when I couldn't fucking fly this plane and now I'm like a fucking pro?
The 2291, delete speed restrictions.
Okay, delete speed restrictions. What speed would you like us at, Delta 2291?
There's no restrictions.
Me, so I can go get another beer.
Doesn't deleting speed restrictions mean...
Delta 2291.
Doesn't deleting speed restrictions mean that it's at your discretion,
hey,
right?
Delta 291, I need 1 minute to step away.
Southwest 291, no problem. You're about to leave Myers Space. The Boston Center is offline. ATC services are terminated and your frequency change approved.
Ah, yes. Okay, thank you,
pleasure.
Tim.
Have a good night.
Tim, fellow airman. Hello, Tim. Fellow aviator. Cleveland Center, Delta 2385, ready for taxi.
Delta 2385, runway 24 left, taxi via Juliet, Juliet 3, Lima, Lima 7. Cleveland Hopkins altimeter 3016.
Juliet, Juliet 3, Lima, Lima 7, Delta 2385. Did I get it right?
Cleveland JetBlue 1293 is off gate, Delta 76 short of Victor 4, ready to
I get it right?
Pittsburgh.
JetBlue 1293, which one do you want to go to?
28 right.
I'm gonna be honest. I did.
Right, taxi,
I'm not gonna follow
Victor,
those instructions.
Bravo,
I'm just gonna
Bravo
get to the runway.
One.
And hope he's not looking.
28 right, Victor, Bravo, Bravo 1, JetBlue 1293.
All right. I'm just going to hope that...
Sunwing 520, leave my airspace. The Boston Center is offline. Montreal appears to be offline as well.
That's what you do, IRL. Tim,
are terminated in your frequency.
Tim, do you fly commercially?
Over Unicom, Sunwing 520. It's been good having it all.
That's badass. Oh, you're a flight instructor. You do regionals next month. Oh, nice. What airplane are you gonna fly? Fuck, I don't know where the taxiway is. It's so dark.
Muxley 201, fly your present heading. Descend and maintain 3,000 radar vectors ILS 23.
ERJ 175, huh? Nice. Get up for Tim, he's an actual pilot. He's not a fake pilot like me.
Southwest 3251, runway 23, Buffalo, cleared to land, Buffalo, wind 210 at 11.
The fuck is this car doing?
Runway 23, Southwest 2351.
Roxy 201, I have no braking action reports tracking here.
Roxy 201, roger.
This airport fucking blows cock. I'm gonna guess 24 left. I gotta look at my map here. Fuck, hold on, let me. Shit.
So 2385, you can take your next right turn, which I think is Mike 2. They'll take you to the DI's pad if you need to use that. And then continue 24 left full length.
Roger, Delta 2385. Shh. Do I need to... He's trying to be friendly to me. Basically, a friendly way to say, you don't know where you're going, but maybe you need to do something there. Oh God. Shit. I'm just lost. I can't see shit.
And Delta 4116, holding short of Whiskey.
4116, okay, parking via your discretion. If you need to, cross 3 left, Main Street.
He said Juliet 1, didn't he?
We'll be crossing 3 left, remain on the frequency, Delta 4116.
4116, how's the braking for you?
About 2 out of 5, I'll get you back.
American 1023, the prior two arrivals at Detroit, only 2 and left, reported 2 out of 5 on the braking.
Roger, we've got that 1023, thanks.
St. Cleveland, JetBlue 1293, ready for departure, 28 right, Pittsburgh.
JetBlue 1293, runway heading, runway 28 right, clear for takeoff, Pittsburgh, wind 260 and 7.
Clear for takeoff, fly runway heading, JetBlue 1293.
Southwest 217, Santec, Indianapolis Center, 119.55.
In the airlines, Tim, do they actually just like taxi the way they want, or do they actually follow?
Southwest 217, Southwest 217, contact Indianapolis Center, 119.55.
Okay, because I don't know where the fuck I'm going. But you know, if I was in real life, I'd like be paying attention a little bit more, probably. This seems like we're on the right track here, though.
Center, good evening. My apologies. Delta 469 had a little family issue I had to deal with there. We're 12 west northwest of Rochester, 317, climbing the 370.
Delta 469, yeah, you're just grazing my airspace there. Nothing for you. Boston Center's offline. Frequency change.
You got it. Thank you so much. Sorry about that. Have a great evening, Delta 469.
It's like we're getting a 2-4 left right now. Alright.
Moxie 201, 5 miles from Edgy, turn left, heading 260, maintain 3,000 to established localizer, cleared ILS 23, African.
Moxie 260, maintain 3,000 to established on localizer, cleared the ILS 23, at Canton, Moxie 201.
Alright. Let's get ready for takeoff here.
St. Cleveland, JetBlue 1293, runway heading, passing 3,000 for 5.
Turn the transponder on.
There we go.
Southwest Brian 251 is off, 23.
Southwest 3251, taxi to parking district.
Look how, this plane looks is so nice.
2351, just so you know, it was probably 2.5 out of 5 for braking action with gusts up to 31 to 1,000 feet above the airport. Southwest 20, correction 3251.
JetBlue 1293, Cleveland, your radar contact. Climb and maintain 17,000. And when you get a chance, squawk code 5773.
17,5773, JetBlue 1293.
Cleveland Center, good evening. ExecJet 360, 265370, about 15 northeast of Niagara Falls.
Call sign again, please.
ExecJet 360.
ExecJet 360, Cleveland Center, radar contact, climb and maintain.
Wait, Terabuck, what did you see? Where did you see?
Climbing 370, exact jet 360.
Leaving center, swift flight 810 over bump 330 from 370.
Oh, where did that get posted? I'm gonna put
Swift flight 810, Cleveland Center. Radar contact.
I'm making a trailer right now with Austin Ox. Austin Ox is
5370, so flight 810.
Cleveland Center, Delta 2385, short of runway 24 left.
The 2385 RNAV Wish, runway 24 left, clear for takeoff, Cleveland, wind 240 at 13.
Clear for takeoff, runway 24 left, Delta 2385. TA only.
JetBlue 1293, turn right heading 020.
Right turn 020, JetBlue 1293.
Hey, what does TA only mean? I feel like I'm missing something.
Moxie 201, runway 23 at Akron Canton, cleared to land. Wind 260 at 14, gust 21.
Runway 23 to land, Moxie 20.
I need to turn on my, shit. One second. I need to turn something on. There's something that I'm missing here.
American 3169er, flight level 300.
I'm on TARA, what the hell?
3169 Cleveland Center, radar
contact.
Oh,
RA comes on when you're in the air, okay.
Yeah, 50 miles west of Buffalo. Maintain flight level 300.
Oh, predictive wind shear off. Turn that on.
Maintain 300 for American 3169.
Okay, here we go.
Sir, so what do you do about 2 minutes? Step out.
I fucking accidentally turned predictive wind shear off instead of on.
Yeah, no problem. Boston Center is offline. You're about to leave my airspace. So your ATC services are terminated and your frequency change.
Alright, let's switch over to you. Come see later. Bye bye.
Delta 2291, we're approaching the end of the star here. Are you going to give us vectors or are we clear to shirk or what?
The 2291, I think the star should give you a track to fly. But Delta 2291 was flying 050 to maintain 5,000 radar vectors ILS.
I don't know how to config the aircraft perfectly, so I get that alert every time.
Okay, what was that headed again?
So 2291 fighting 050.
050, descend and maintain 5,000, Delta 2291.
I love the way this plane flies though. It's so nice. So much fun to fly.
American 1023, you have an estimated time of arrival.
We're looking at about 70 more nautical miles at estimated at 1631 Zulu time for 1023.
1631 Zulu? I think we're on different planets here.
I may be turning into a little bit of an Airbus guy. It's kind of like...
About 16 hours or something like that, right?
I've got 0345 Zulu, so okay.
Sometime between now and about an hour from here.
All right, well, let's try this. Attention aircraft, Cleveland Center closing at approximately 0400 Zulu.
What time is 0400 Zulu?
Cleveland Center, I know you're getting ready to close. I was just getting ready to check in. This is Southwest 1292 or 31 southwest of Detroit VOR, and we can switch back to Unicom if you want.
Southwest 1292, Cleveland Squawk 5765.
5765, Southwest 1292, and turn flight level.
I'm hand flying this thing way more than I ever do the
Boeing. Radar contact climb and maintain level 270 and clear direct. Duker. 2291, descend and maintain 3000.
Descend and maintain 3000, Delta 2291.
Delta 2385, radar contact, climb and maintain flight level 270, clear direct Duker.
Clear direct Duker, flight level 270, Delta 2385. I don't know.
Mossy 201, cross runway 1, taxi to parking this frequency.
Cross runway 1, and taxi to parking this
frequency. Autopilot engaged. Open climb.
Delta 2291, turn up heading 320.
320, Delta 2291.
American 3169, descend and maintain 12000 Cleveland Hopkins altimeter 3016. American 3169, descend and maintain 12000 Cleveland Hopkins altimeter 3016.
Descend and maintain 12000 altimeter 3016 for American 3169, thank you.
Hold on. D-U-U-K-R.
St. Cleveland Center, JetBlue 1293. Any chance direct Phillipsburg VOR?
Oh, hello, JetBlue 1293. Sorry about that. Clear direct Phillipsburg.
All right, not a problem. Direct Phillipsburg, JetBlue 1293.
Exact Jet 360, we have Myers Space, Boston, offline. ATC services are terminated. Frequency change approved.
All right, we're on our way to Buffalo.
Good night, Exact Jet 360.
Let's get some good jams on, huh?
2291, turn up heading 250, joining the islands from way 24 right, left, measure that.
All right, Delta 2291, what was the heading?
The 2291 radar vectors across the localizer now. Turn left, heading 210.
Left 210, Delta 2291.
Flight over the American 2885.
Delta 2291 is 14 miles from the airport. Turn left, heading 210. 210 heading. Maintain 3000 to establish the localizer. Clear your ILS runway 24 right approach.
Left
210 until established on the localizer and maintain 3000 Delta and cleared for the ILS. Delta 2291.
American 2885,
yeah, sorry about that. Apparently I didn't know my mic was working until now.
American 2885, Cleveland, squawk 5757.
5757
2885. This is so fucking cozy. I'm so
1023,
into
1023,
click
the ILS runway 21 left approach.
Right, 21 left approach for 1023, thanks.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, aviators.
2885, Cleveland radar contact. 70 miles east of Pittsburgh, give or take. You leave my airspace. New York Center is offline. ATC services are terminated and your frequency change is approved. Thanks for checking in.
Back to you in the Gommel
Street. Southwest 719 Cleveland Center.
Do these messages trigger you?
5711.
5711.
I get the right call sign, Southwest 719.
719, correct.
How do I clear them?
No, I got you. Sorry.
How do I clear these?
Delta 2291, runway 24 right, clear to land, wind 240 at 15.
24 right, clear to land, Delta 2291.
I'm trying to climb faster, but I just lower the speed, I suppose. Get at that altitude. You guys like these vibes? Cozy vibes?
Did you hear the...
Cleveland Hawks, good information. Lima is now currently at altimeter 3017.
I saw the allegations of me being under the influence of marijuana. I'd like to deny those. You want me to turn off the lights?
FlexJet 3277, Cleveland Center, radar contact.
How about that?
Is
that better?
Maintain 4430.
Maintain 430, FlexJet 3277.
Oh, in my room. No. I need to be able to see myself.
Cleveland, good evening. Delta 5977 descending through flight level 240.
You think, are you telling me the light in my room is throwing off the vibe?
Cleveland Center. Walk right in.
All right, hold on. Is that better?
Delta 5977 radar contact 40 southeast of Buffalo. Descend and maintain 10,000 Buffalo altimeter 3.
I may need to turn the light on in the plane a little bit more.
10,000 Delta 5977.
Are you okay with this much light in here? Standard. Perfect. It's beginning to
sounds like Michael Jackson.
What? What is he talking about, Michael Jackson? Is the holly that will be
3169, welcome back.
So last weekend I decorated my whole living room with Christmas decorations. It's so fucking cozy. I have a little fireplace, I got the tree, I got the stockings, I've got some stuff over the fireplace, I've got some lights over my piano.
Yeah.
I've got just candles, little Christmas candles. I've got lights going up the stairs. I've got my grandmother passed away about one of my grandmothers passed away about 7 years ago, and she loved Christmas, and so I inherited all her Christmas decorations. As tribute, I put up a couple of her Christmas decorations every year. She was a very elegant woman. She had like she always shopped at like Nordstrom. That was her thing. And she, what's that really like, I guess Clinique? Is Clinique, like, back in the day it used to be like the only skincare brand that you would do. Is not Clinique. Is it Clinique? Not Clinique. It was like a really...
Trans Auto 722.
Was Clinique Holy like one of the one like the best ones back in the day? I know Clinique is still good, but like back in the day. So I think she used...
I didn't Trans Auto 722.
Yeah, I think it was Clinique. Yeah, because she was an older lady. I mean, let's be real. I had old ass grandparents.
Delta 2291 is clear the runway.
2291, cross runway 24 left, 2 parking, this frequency.
Like, all my grandparents died...
cross 24 left, 2 parking on this frequency.
From 2011 to 2019, they all died in that time frame.
Cleveland Center, good evening. American 3941 will be in flight level 37.
I don't have any living grandparents. Kind of sucks. Cleveland Center. Christmas kind of changes. The holidays change when your grandparents die. It's kind of sad.
American 3169, cross Budrow. at or above 5,000. That photo cleared ILS runway 24.
But life goes on. Life goes on.
Cross Boulder at 5,000 feet or above for runway 24 right, American 3167.
Record 1023, is going to maintain 3,000.
3,000 for 1023.
I just want some snow this Christmas. That's my favorite. I love the snow. It makes me happy.
Watch that 3277 cross Easton at maintain 17,000. The Buffalo area altimeter 3003.
Was that for
Can you repeat
me?
That for FlexJet 3277?
FlexJet 3277 cross Easton intersection at and maintain 17,000.
Cross Easton at 17,000, FlexJet 3277.
This is Easton intersection on the Ling 3 arrival. Easton, just without the P.
What part of Oregon are you from, Axe of Brevity?
Oh, I got it now. Sorry about that. Easton, 3277.
All right, we are at our
and
cruise altitude, folks.
Radar contact 5 west of the St. Thomas, via war maintain, federal 320.
Maintain 320, transat at 722.
Cleveland 72, could you please call from passing altitude for Budrow for American 3169?
American 3169 crossed Budrow at or above 5,000. That Budrow cleared ILS runway 24 right.
Crossed Budrow at 5 or above 5,000 for runway 24 right, American 3169. Thank you.
JetBlue 1293, I'm failing all around. Climb maintain.
Are you saying cockpit?
All right, flyable 250, JetBlue 1293.
Cockpit's too bright. You want me to
American
darken
1023,
it?
Turn left heading 270.
Left heading 270, 1023.
Walker
1118,
level 1100. Walker 1118, Cleveland Center, send and maintain 10,000, Pittsburgh, altimeter 3018.
Is the cockpit too bright?
Send, maintain 10,000, Walker 1118.
Walker 1118, Pittsburgh, wind 260 at 7. You want the ILS runway 28 left or the ILS runway 32?
I'm going to be honest, I wish we didn't have ATC right now. I kind of want to just fly myself.
28 left.
Level 5977 flying 050 to maintain 5,000.
050 5,000 Delta 5977.
Level 2385 descend upon discretion maintain 11,000 Buffalo area altimeter 3003.
Descend at my discretion to 11,000 Delta 2385.
Southwest 1292 descend upon discretion maintain level 280.
Level 280 Southwest 1292 and I've got a provisional hotel.
So. I don't know.
1023 is 20 miles from the airport. Turn left heading 240. Maintain 3,000 till established level cleared ILS.
Yeah, this fucking flight is fast. It's like faster
than. Left heading 240. Maintain 3,000 till established cleared ILS. 21 left approach 1023.
JetBlue 1293, you get to talk to a better controller now. New York Center is offline. ATC sources are terminated. Freak change route.
Okay, sounds good. 22.8 for JetBlue 1293.
The path is too steep, but. When should we start descending? Tim, what do you think? What do you want for Christmas?
Yeah,
I'm going to be honest. I just
get,
want...
one refill tonight.
I just want some good...
Ruh-roh.
I'm very simple. I'm a simple man, okay? You know what I'm saying? I'm not even going to finish my sentence. I'm a simple man. That's all I can say. I'm a very simple man. That's it. Like that's all I wanted for my birthday.
977 send to maintain 3.
That's all I want. Make me
3,000 up 5977.
That's how you make me happy in a relationship. Men only want one thing. You're damn right. You're damn right.
Walker 1118 fly heading 070, descend maintain 10,000. Radar vectors ILS from my 28 left.
Heading 070 at 10,000, Walker 1118.
All right, let's turn on the seatbelt sign. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. We're about to begin our initial descent into Buffalo. I've asked the flight attendants to.
Turn up heading 320.
Finish their cabin service early as we're expecting some turbulence as we descend into the Buffalo area. Local time in Buffalo, 11 p.m. 30 degrees Fahrenheit with scattered snow showers. We know you have many choices when you fly. We do appreciate you choosing Delta Airlines, and we'll have you on the ground in about 25 minutes.
You're braking action on 2-4, right?
Yeah, Delta 2291. We didn't really have any trouble there.
Thank you. American 3169, braking action. All right,
guys.
Runway 24 reported as no trouble.
We are descending.
No trouble as runway 24 right for American 2169. I think.
We are descending, guys, to Buffalo, and
runway 24 right,
it's supposed to be icy and snowy.
230 at 11, and gusting 21.
Winds copies, American 2169, Cleveland.
Holy shit, the visibility is low! Yes! 1/14 mile visibility. Looks like it's snowing. Hell yeah! I'm so excited! I don't know what the fuck my minimums are. I'm landing regardless.
5977 is 15 miles from Clump, flying 260, maintained 3,000 until established. Localizer cleared ILS from way 23, Buffalo.
Left 260, maintain 2,000 to the service, clear the left 23 at Buffalo, Delta 5977.
Delta 1292, send at pilot discretion, maintain 11,000, the Buffalo altimeter.
There's a lot of people going to Buffalo right now.
11,000, Delta 1292.
Because of the storm, everybody wants to do it in Flight Simulator. It's kind of fucked up, you know? When there's danger, everybody just wants to experience it. It's a thrill.
23, runway 21 left. Cleared to land Detroit, wind 230 at 17. Prior two arrivals were A320s reported braking action 2 out of 5, approximately 30 minutes ago.
Wind, it's not super windy.
Okay, Roger, 21 left, clear to land, and we're on Boeing, so we should probably be waiting in those airplanes.
Oh, fuck. Hell yeah, brother. Did you guys hear that? So if you weren't listening, basically the air traffic controller said that the Airbus that landed before him reported braking action 2 out of 5. So like the ability to brake was like a 2 out of 5. And he's like, don't worry, brother, we're flying a Boeing. We should be able to brake better than him. What's a good Christmas song for snow? Lay Ryan, there we go.
Walker 1118, descend at pilot discretion, maintain 7,000.
Descend, maintain 7,000, pilot discretion, Walker 1118.
Good evening. Cleveland Center, Endeavour 2475, pick up our request to Detroit.
This is
Endeavour,
the sleigh bells ringling,
2475. Endeavour 2475, Cleveland Center, clear to the Detroit Metro Airport via the Buffalo 8 departure radar vectors, Doneo, Top Gun 2, arrival. Maintain 10,000, expect level 3201 minutes after departure, squawk 5764, and be advised Cleveland Center is closing in about 5-10 minutes.
Oh shit, the ATC is closing in like 5 to 10 minutes.
Okay, Endeavour 2475 is cleared to Detroit by the Buffalo 8 departure, Top Gun 2 arrival, and what's the clock again?
5764.
Okay, squawk 5764, Endeavour Transport.
Acts of Brevity, do you go to U of O?
Runway 23 for departure, call for taxi.
Runway 23 for departure, call for taxi, Endeavour Transport.
What year are you?
So 2385, clear direct Trava.
Can we get the phonetic spelling of that, Delta 2385?
2385, clear direct Trava, Tango, Romeo, Alpha, Victor, Alpha. It is the initial approach fix from runway 23.
Clear direct Travo, initial approach fix for runway 23, Delta 2385. That should be this one, right? That's this one. I see.
So 5977 runway 23 at Buffalo, clear to land wind at Buffalo 200 at 15.
That must be this one.
23, Delta 5977.
So 2385, descend upon discretion, maintain 4.
He said Travo or Trava? I mean, you'd think that this is it, right? Trava? Okay.
Delta 2385, descend upon discretion, maintain 4,000.
Descent my discretion down to 4,000, Delta 2385.
Delta 2385, expect the full approach with the course reversal from Trava. Cleveland's going to be closing here shortly.
We'll expect the full approach, 2385. I don't know what the fuck...
Southwest 1292.
I don't know what that means.
After the Dunkirk beacon, clear direct...
Tim, I don't know what the fuck he meant by that, Tim.
Full approach, ILS 23.
I don't know what that means.
After Dunkirk, direct Trava, and I will expect...
He said something along the lines of expect the full back course approach, which I imagine it just means we're going to fly all the way to Trava and turn around. I don't know.
Walker 1118 to 718, 5,000 field, 11 o'clock, 10 miles. If you get inside, let me know.
We'll descend 5,000 and look for field, Walker 1118.
Field will cast 4,000 now. Okay,
never mind. We have the field, Walker 1118.
That's amazing. Walker 1118 cleared visual runway 28 left approach.
What does non-precision approach mean? Does that just mean that it's like...
Walker 1118.
You eyeball it or what?
Walker 1118, Cleveland Center is closing. Pittsburgh Airport is not otherwise staffed. Your ATC services are terminated and your peak change approved. No traffic observed between you and the airport, and no known traffic on the airport either.
Over to
Unicom,
thank you very much for the service.
I don't know, Tim. I'm not a pilot. What do I look like, a pilot?
An American 1023 tank.
That's what I say. It doesn't make sense to do a non-precision approach on an ILS, right? Isn't that what an ILS is? Is a precision approach? There's no glide slope?
3941 Cleveland Center is closing. Your ATC services are terminated. Free change. Okay. Southwest 719 Cleveland Center is closing. ATC
Run
services
ILS runway 23.
Let's check 3277. Nobody home at Toronto. Your ATC services are terminated. Free change approved. No traffic observed between you and the airport.
Over to Unicom. Thanks for the service. Flexjet 3277. Have a good night.
So 2385, Delta 2 leaving.
Go again for 2385.
So 2385, say altitude leaving.
Leaving 8400.
Southwest 1292, descend and maintain 900,000.
900,000, Southwest 1292.
Transauto 722. Cleveland Center is closing. Indianapolis Center is offline. ATC services are terminated. Free change free.
Oh, God.
Cool. All right. American 3169 cross runway 24 left. Two parking. This frequency.
Cross runway 24 left for American 3169 gate at our distribution. Thank you for ATC.
Transauto 722.
Transauto 722, go ahead.
Transauto 722, Cleveland Center is closing. Indy is already closed. ATC services are terminated. Frequency change approved.
Frequency change approved. Have a good night, Transauto 722.
Route 2385, cross Trava at 4000. At Trava, cleared ILS runway 23, Buffalo.
Cross Trava. At 4,000, cleared ILS runway 23 at Buffalo, Delta 2385. I descended too quickly. That's all right. Are we in the clouds right now? It doesn't look as
bad. Endeavor 2475, push right for taxi.
Number 2475, runway 23, taxi via Alpha, cross runway 32.
Alpha, cross 32, Endeavor 2475, we're going to switch over to incoming now or wait for a minute until we depart.
Yeah, Unicom, actually, monitor this frequency for just a little bit here. We'll set some stuff up.
Okay, we'll just monitor you for now, just monitor out, so letting your whip clip a little, just monitor your frequency for now.
5977, 2 parking is frequency.
Parking, 5977.
So 2385, your sequence is number 1 for the field. There's one departure that might sneak out prior to your arrival. So at Treva, do the course reversal, head back in. Make sure you announce on Unicom, because there is an aircraft following behind you that's doing the same thing. You'll stay at 5,000 until you clear Treva inbound.
Delta 2385, we'll make sure we communicate with surrounding aircraft on Unicom. Appreciate your help.
All right, Delta 2385, your ATC services are now terminated and your frequency change approved.
Over to 122.8. Have a great evening. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Southwest 1290.
All right. Buffalo traffic, Delta 2385, 14 miles from Treva, which will cross at 4,000 Buffalo traffic.
Present traffic, Delta 8842, crossing Eastbound, all link tree arrival for LS 182 for left.
How low are we? Jesus Christ, look out where the ground is. Where's my terrain? Look at this. The airport must be over here somewhere. We're gonna be all right. Tim, tell him we're gonna be all right. Don't worry. Oh, there we go. What did Tim say? We're fucked. Tim, come on, Tim. I've never crashed. We are low to the ground, though. That's interesting. All right, we're gonna make our turn here.
Buffalo traffic, Endeavor 2475 is going to be taking runway 23 at Buffalo.
Okay. Buffalo traffic, Delta 2385, crossing Treva, making a right-hand turn towards runway 23, Buffalo traffic. I hope I'm communicating that correctly. I don't know what the fuck. My link. my ability to like speak properly is like gone out the window.
Buffalo traffic, Endeavor 2475 is going to be departing 23 right on the Buffalo 7, maintaining under 6,000 until we pass the southwest Endeavor 2475.
It seems like we're pretty low to the ground, but I don't know. I'm gonna slow us down here. Are we hitting the glide slope? Is there no glide slope on this? It's above me? It's the diamond? Are we? Oh, so we're about to hit it. Oh, I see. So we're good. Oop, I don't want to slow that slow. Okay, we're good. We're about to hit it. There it is, right there. Glide slope. Okay. Yeah. Go max auto brake.
Buffalo traffic, Endeavor 2475 is clear of Q3, maintaining our own navigation.
And Buffalo traffic, Southwest 1292 is crossing over top of the field at 7,000, gonna begin descent down to 5,000.
All right, we are approaching Buffalo right now in the middle of a snowstorm. Currently, the visibility is very low.
2,500.
Holy shit. Let's slow to our final approach speed, huh? Wait, did my fucking speed freeze here? Oh no. Is it frozen? Or is it just stuck like that? Okay, it's snowing. Like, do you guys see how my speed is like not moving? Like, uh-oh. Oh shit. Oh no. I don't know why the speed is broken. The gear is not changing the speed. Oh fuck. Uh-oh. Oh my god. Oh my god. No. Like, it's not... I don't know. Oh, fuck. I don't know what our speed is. It's frozen. We're gonna stall.
Speed.
Oh shit. I mean, I can't, it's frozen. It's like we're, use the steam gauges? That's cheating. I mean, this is so dangerous. This is so dangerous. I don't have
1,000.
I mean, I just hope that we're at a good speed. I don't know. What do you mean? Hand fly the plane. The speed's broken.
Speed, speed, speed.
Oh my God! Okay, we're going around.
Buffalo traffic, Southwest 1292 is over Trav at 5000, beginning the circle back to the islands, runway 23, Buffalo.
Buffalo traffic, Delta 2385, going around, missed approach, runway 23, Buffalo. Okay, somebody's got to tell me why I don't have my speed gauge stop working. Can somebody tell me what's going on? Is it frozen? What the fuck's the deal? Oh, my pitot tube's off? Oh, fuck. I thought I had them. Oh, no. Wait, my pitot tubes? Where are they? I don't even know how to get those on again. Oh, God. Probe heat. Guys, look. Probe heat has been on this whole time. Probe heat is on. I just don't have any speed. I can't. We need to get above this weather. Okay, my speed's coming back to, at least my Mach number is. Yeah, all my de-icing is on as well. Hold on. We're gonna get out of this, guys. Just give me... Hold on. Tim. I could turn the auto throttle on, but I don't think the plane knows what speed we're at. Okay, we're out of the we're getting out of the moisture here, but guys, seriously, I think I need to get up higher here. All right, we need to fix this. Shit. Yeah.
Buffalo traffic, Southwest 1292 is established back on the runway 23.
Where the fuck are we turning? Okay, Tim, look at my overhead panel here. My probe heat has been on. My anti-ice is on. Yeah, maybe I should have. Then why is my speed freezing? It doesn't make sense. Is the speed in selected speed mode? What does that mean? Yeah, that's a good point. This Southwest Airlines pilot is helping me. All right, let's go. I'm trying to go back to Buffalo now. I don't know how to do it. Flight plan. I'm gonna be honest, guys. I don't know if we're gonna land safely. I can't believe I'm saying this. I don't know what to do. I really don't. We're basically increasing our speed. We're hauling ass. I've got a Mach number. Let's change it to... Hold on. Do you guys know how I can return back to Buffalo with this thing? God, none of you guys know how to fly, do you? Not departure. I need arrival. Fuck. Fuck. I know direct, but direct what? Fuck. I'm gonna have to look, do it manually. Son of a bitch. Okay, I'm gonna go direct Trava. Okay, I'm gonna do that. I'm going Mach 0.75. The fucking plane cannot control its speed. We're already 60 miles from Trava. All right. Guys, hey Tim, this has got to be a glitch, right? Like, this isn't... I've got everything on that I need to have on, right? Yeah, I know. But I did put it on CL, but it won't follow, like, the speed that I put it at. It just, like, accelerates to some random... So I need to somehow set the ILS for Buffalo, but I don't. But it won't let me select a anything like that. So this is what I have to do. I need to somehow program the ILS for runway 23 at Buffalo. I just don't know how I'm going to do that without knowing how to do that with the FMS. Okay, rad nav. Okay. Okay, yeah, it's a good idea. Okay, let's do this. Departure. ILS, 2.3, so that 111.3, okay, slash one. And the course is... Course is 235. Okay, so if I put it in correctly, F235? What? Do I have to put it in brackets like that? God, the Airbus is so fucking confusing. Fuck this plane. Okay. What the who fucking invented this stupid shit? Like, it's... Boeing is so much more intuitive. Like, fuck. Does anybody know the intersection that was after Trava on that approach? Let's see. Oh, it's right here. So after Trava, it's... Clump. And then after Clump, it's... Wabus. Oh, that's the go-around. All right. All right, guys, we're just gonna have to pray. The guy that messaged me, I've never done an approach where I have to guess my speed. This is going to be the first time. So, wish us luck, huh? We'll need it. Oh, I guess I do have my ground speed. I guess you're right. Fuck. That's my ground speed. I don't know how I'm going to be able to turn that into, like, my final approach speed. How do I, near the ground, your TAS is very similar to your ground. Okay. All right. As we get on our final approach, you mean? Yeah, we're going a little too fast, huh? Okay. All right. Thanks, Tim. We got it. This is definitely a learning experience for me. Why did that happen? Am I too slow or something? What the fuck's the deal? What is it doing? Dude, this fucking plane is insane. Dude, what the fuck is going on? This plane is insane. Like, it's actually insane. We've got the localizer. I mean, I was looking at... Is TAS like the...
Buffalo traffic, United 1307, clear of 23 Golf, final call, Buffalo.
Alright, we're just gonna do the best we fucking can. Guys, you told me TAS is like an accurate representation of your speed, but it doesn't seem like that's the case. When I slowed down, Tim, right, I'm gonna slow it down like you said, but watch what happens. Slow it down, Tim. What's more accurate, ground speed or TAS? What should I be looking at? Okay, TAS, thank you. So I'm still fast. Give it about 10, a plus 10. Get back to the center line. I don't even know where the fucking runway is. I'm just gonna pray that we fucking even get there. Oh, I fucking had the flaps fucking not down all the way.
1,000.
Okay. Holy shit. Oh, holy shit. Holy shit.
300.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Holy shit.
200.
Oh my god. Oh my. Oh my god. Oh my god. This is insane. This is insane.
Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low gear. Too low terrain.
Oh my god, my gear. My speed has come alive again.
Too low terrain. Too low gear. Too low terrain.
My speed's alive again.
Too low terrain. Too low terrain.
Fuck. Fuck. All right, now that my... Oh, and it died again. And my... No, it didn't. Fucking son of a bitch. Okay, my speed's alive again. So now maybe I can fly the fucking plane? I should have landed? No, I couldn't. I didn't even. I was way off center anyway. Okay, let's try again. We didn't die, we had to go around again. Okay. Alright, direct. I want to make a... shit. Ah, fuck. My speed's frozen again. God damn it. Fucking son of a bitch. I don't know how I'm gonna land. I really don't. I just don't. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing wrong. Like, I really honestly have no fucking idea what's going on. Go to settings, general, experimental, and then, that's cool. And then, I'm gonna go off. What was it? New gauge option? Off. Oh my god. Did I just got trolled. I just got trolled. Oh my god, what the fucking, you asshole. You son of a bitch. Oh god, I hope this brings them back. Oh no. It's gone? Ah. Guys, that is so fucked. Fuck that. That's so mean. That is so mean. We didn't collide with anything. That was a glitch. That was a glitch. Because we were at like 5,000 feet, so there's no way that... That is... Look, I'm going to be real with you. I don't know how to fix that situation. I don't know what the fuck happened. But that is like not... There's some... That's some sort of glitch. Our Annie Ice was on. Our Probe Heat was on. Someone said the icing settings are incompatible with the plane from the dev. Yeah, so that was a fucking glitch and it ruined our flight. That's so lame. That's so lame. And by the way, the reason that the game crashed is because the Phoenix, like the computer, like lost connection with the simulator. I should have just landed. I should have just put it down and landed. I mean, I was on top of the runway, but like I didn't know how much room I had left. And so I just decided to fucking. Yeah. Damn. I mean, I should have landed the first time, to be honest. I should have just kept going and landed the first time. Yeah, we'll try another flight this weekend to Buffalo. I'll get you there safely. We'll fly a different airline. But yeah, we'll do it in the daylight. It'll be prettier during the daylight anyways. But we'll reset. It was a glitch. Sorry guys. Fucked up, but it's all good. We'll do it again maybe sometime this weekend, maybe tomorrow morning. So all right, guys. Have a good night. Peace out. Is anybody streaming right now? Will streaming? Oh, cutie.
Some FTP Skull Krunic for $65.
Thank you. You got this one. They got this one.
See, it's like you can't go wrong with either, truly.
Oh, someone got the purple
this
one.
This one's
smile.
The best one. Yeah, she is really good.
Oh all right, guys, go watch Cutie.
Snacking, and then it's going to be really fun. I thought we'd be in a happier mood. I was instantly grumpy because of tech issues, but I seem to have fixed,
Nope.
Or did you guys just get scared of complaining?
Love the merch.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Take care, guys.